But in the book, they make changes. They write something. If someone comes to them for some worldly need, or to ask some fatwa or some other situation, and if it is not in the Torah, they will write down something and say, yeah, it's in the Torah. Okay, go and do it. So this is writing the book with their own hands. ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ Then they say, these Jews say, هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ This is from Allah. They write with their own hand, and after writing, they say, this writing which is there is actually from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is actually in Torah. Okay? Why do they do that? لِيَشْتَرُوا So they can take, they can earn something, they can buy or sell something, trade something, bihi with this writing, thamanan qalila, a very small price. For a very small price, they just tell the person that, yes, this is the order of Allah, go and do it. And they get little money out of that person. So this is, they trade, they sell what they write for a small amount of, qalil means small, Samana is the price. For a small price, they tell people that, yeah, this is written in the Torah, even though it is not written in the Torah. So that's how they can get some benefit out of these people in terms of the worldly things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ Woe unto them, or may they be destroyed. Mimma katabat aydihim of that what they actually wrote with their hands, wawailul lahum and may they be destroyed or woe upon them. Mimma yaksibun what they are earning. Yaksibun is from kasab. Kasab means to earn something. So what they are earning, what they are gaining, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this is a very sad and sorrowful situation for them, and may they be destroyed. It's like a cursing. Okay. So, you know, sadness upon them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالُوا And they say, لَن تَمَسَّنَ النَّارُ The fire will never touch us. An-nar is the fire. Lan in Arabic means never. Okay. La means not, but lan means never. Okay. So this tamassan is from mas. Mas means to touch something. It's barely touching something is called mas. Okay. So they are saying that fire will never touch us. The fire, an-nar, the fire of hell, will never touch us illa except ayyamam ma'duda few days that can be counted. Ayyam means days, ma'duda from ta'dad or adad, something that can be counted on fingers, for example. So they said even if we were sent to the hellfire, it's going to be only for few days we will be coming out, because we are the chosen people. Okay. Majority of the Jews present day, I would say almost all of them, do not believe that there is a hereafter. They do not believe that there is a day of judgment. They do not believe that there is a hellfire. This is not part of their belief at all. It's very amazing that they are the keeper of the Torah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Musa alayhi salam in multiple times reminded them about the world and the hereafter. But in Judaism, they have taken out the concept of hereafter, Yawm al-Qiyamah. Okay? They have a very limited concept of a world which is called Gahannam, which is actually the Jahannam. Okay? What that concept is that if someone is really, really, really bad among Jews in this world, for a day or two, after he dies, his soul will burn into that fire and will come out. After he dies, his soul will go for a day or two or so into that place they call Gahannam. Okay. Actually, you can search on the internet and just type the concept of hereafter among Jews. You will get all these details. There is no hereafter. Only the word Gehenna, which is a few days. And this is some, and the possibility. Okay. Not all of them, because they are chosen people. So they have taken out the concept, and that's the reason they want to live in this life forever, because they don't have the concept of the hereafter or the life after death. So they want to live, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the ayat is coming there, they want to live thousands of years. If they be allowed, then they would live very, very long life, but they still have to die. So this is what they are saying, that if ever fire touched them, that will be for few days. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding them, قُلْ أَتَّخَسْتُمْ O Prophet, say to them. قُلْ is say, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet from in this Quran, قُلْ say, أَتَّخَسْتُمْ Have you taken إِنْدَ اللَّهِ with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَهْدًا a promise. Have you taken a covenant or a promise with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Allah has made a promise with you? فَلَيْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ So Allah will not do against أَهْدَهُ His promise. أَمْ تَقُولُونَ Or you say, أَمْ تَقُولُونَ Or you say, or you are saying, عَلَى اللَّهِ Upon Allah, مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ That which you don't know. You are saying something upon Allah, which you don't know, you are making a lie, you are creating a lie, as if Allah has made a commitment with you, a promise with you, that if He never punished you, He will just punish you for a few days in the hellfire. Is this something that Allah has promised to you, or you have made up this on your own, and you are saying something which you don't know? Bala man kasaba, no, but whoever earned Man kasaba, whoever earned sayyatan, evil. Sayya means evil. Hasana is the opposite. Hasana means good deed. Sayya is the opposite of hasana, bad deed or evil deed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that no, but whoever has earned evil deed wa ahatat and has surrounded bihi khati'atuhu. His errors or his sins have surrounded him. فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ Then those people are those who will go to the nar, the heaven. هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ And they will abide therein. Okay? They are going to abide. خالدون, the one who lives there for long, long time. Okay? On the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا And those who believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And those who did good deeds. Salihat means good deeds. Okay. أُولَٰئِكَ Those are, such are, أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ The people of the paradise. أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ The people of fire. The opposite of that, أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ The people of the paradise. Channa is garden of paradise. Hum fiha khalidu. They will live therein forever. Okay. So the people who believe and who did good deeds, these are the people who will go to paradise. They will be the ashabul janna, and that's where they will reside forever. Okay. I think this is a good point, because after that, a different type of this more story continues, but it's the end of the ruku also, ruku number 9. So maybe we can stop at this point. Some people can make go to Isha is at 8:15. So inshallah we'll continue after. So we finish up to ayah number 82. Sadaqallahu Maulana al-Azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the effort from us.